It's the Chinese year of the tiger right now, but the future of those animals in the huge Asian country isn't looking so good. Conservationists say that one species of tiger, the South China tiger, is all but extinct. But that doesn't mean they're just going to give up. A special program is spending up big and taking some of the few endangered tigers left on an overseas holiday to help. They once prowled the world. Tens of thousands of big cats. It's a scary thought. Now, a zoo is the most likely place to see one.
The situation for tigers looks extremely bleak at the moment.
Conservationists say there are about 3,200 of these amazing animals left in the wild. 100 years is all it's taken for tiger numbers to drop dramatically. Their habitats have shrunk and many have been hunted for their body parts, which are used in some Chinese medicines. Others are killed for their skins. But tiger researchers are using the Chinese Year of the Tiger this year as a motivation to get out there and turn things around. One of the species of tiger most at risk is the South China tiger. There are said to be only about 30 left in the wild. Something had to be done to save them, so this woman decided to take some on a holiday to Africa. Lee Kwan used to work in expensive fashion stores, but after a trip to Africa, she decided to work with fur in a very different way.
I went there and I saw, to my complete surprise, the entire ecosystem was not only the leopards, but lions and, you know, elephants and crocodiles. It was just so amazing. It was an emotional experience for me. If China can have something like this, if China can have an ecosystem and national park with all the kind of indigenous Chinese animals, then probably it may change the frame mind of Chinese people. Probably they will want to help more the wildlife.
She's now set up a new kind of breeding program for the tigers that's seen as pretty controversial. She takes them out of zoos in China and brings them to Africa, where they can be slowly released into wildlife parks. That's a pretty crazy idea, because while lions are everywhere here, tigers are native to Asia only. But it seems they're liking the change in scenery. Once more are bred, some will be taken back to China and released into special reserves there. They hope to create a whole new wild population for China to call its own. Not everyone is a fan of the idea though. Some wildlife groups say it's far too expensive to keep doing. The scheme has already cost nearly 22 million bucks. Some groups even say the South China tiger is so close to extinction that people should just let it go and focus on saving other tiger species.
The chance of them coming together and the population increasing is pretty unlikely. So that's why we call them basically ecologically extinct.
But others, like Lee Kwan, say they're not leaving any good tiger behind. But more must be done before we see the South China tigers roaming the wild freely once more.